ultimate goal is concerned, I think none of us need have any apprehension. None of us need have any doubt. But my fear, which I must express clearly, is this. Our difficulty, as I said, is not about the ultimate future. Our difficulty is how to make the heterogeneous mass that we have today take a decision in common and march in a cooperative way on that road which is bound to lead us to unity. Our difficulty is not with regard to the ultimate. Our difficulty is with regard to the beginning. Mr. Chairman, therefore, I should have thought that in order to make a start, in order to induce every party, every section in this country, it would be the act of greatest statesmanship for the majority party even to make a concession to the prejudices of people who are not prepared to march together. And it is for this that I propose to make this appeal. Let us leave aside slogans. Let us leave aside words which frighten people. Let us even make concession to the prejudices of our opponents. Bring them in so that they may willingly join with us on marching upon that road, which, as I said, if we walk long enough, must necessarily lead us to unity. And if I, therefore, from this place, support Dr. Jaikar's amendment, it is because I want all of us to realize that whether we are right or wrong, whether the position that we take is consonant with our legal rights, whether that accords with the statement of May 16th or December 16th, leave all that aside. This is too big a question to be reduced to the position of mere legality. It is not a legal question. I say leave aside all these considerations and make some attempt whereby those who are not prepared to come will come. Let us make it possible for them to come. That is my opinion. In the course of the debate that took place, there were two questions which were raised.